So I'm gonna try to get away with sneaking into a casino and gonna go gamble.
I think you'll be escorted out of the premises, but try it. Let me know. But it's good. It's good to fight. It's good. I saw some. The Zone released some nice videos.
Yeah, they did. They actually did. The
poster in that video was really good.
The poster?
Yeah, the white one.
I didn't see it.
Or the you posted it. It's the picture.
The one Virgil posted it.
Yeah.
Yeah. That one.
Nice.
Oh yeah. Oh,
you need to
one.
Save some of those and print them, or ask them for copies.
Yeah. I've asked for them to send me the picture.
The files, yeah.
But it doesn't blow up that big. I don't know. We'll see. But we're gonna try to put them on shirts.
Thank you, Goris. Appreciate it. That's
the
true.
The guy with the voice of the History Channel.
No, 24/7.
Oh, 24/7.
The voiceover.
Voiceover.
Hey, it's good they're calling you the future of boxing now and not when you're 30 and 0 with like 28 knockouts.
Well, that's the future.
I know, but I'm saying.
Future of boxing has 3 fights left.
It's a warm day today here. It's a busy day at the gym. Fight week. So I saw, I posted yesterday Ryan Garcia against Virgil Ortiz, and I saw you work in the corner.
Yeah.
How many fights have you worked for Virgil in the amateurs?
Virgil.
Since 2000 and... After I fought Jordan White. I don't know what year that was.
We were still working in the gym, but your dad was going to the tournaments. To the nationals, at least.
I think it was like 13.
13?
So you would say 5 years, 6 years?
Yeah. That's...
8.
It was 2012.
2012?
It was 2012 because I remember you trained me for when I fought Bruce Carrington.
Oh yeah.
Thank you, Boris. That's what I'm saying. Like people don't realize that it's actually been me, Hector, Beltrana, Gene Vivero, and Yuli,
Hector's brother,
who's been training Virgil from the get-go. It hasn't been nobody else. Nobody in California, nobody in Texas. It's the four people. We're the ones that have been training him. And so when people ask, like, how come so-and-so don't train him? Because we're the one that brought him up. We've made him. So then, of course, then I get the...
That was at the Junior Olympics,
I asked for the people to...
That was at the Junior Olympics?
Like, you know, when you fought Bruce coach in there that could possibly bring something in on the team.
Yeah, I fought him at Junior Olympics,
and that's what I do. You know, I bring people in.
I think
you should always be open to help. Like, you should always know, like, okay, this person can benefit me in this way. This person, that's how you get up, not by feeling like, oh, I can do it by myself, or no, this coach is the only way. Because really, this is not just one way. There's several ways. But again, you know, that's why we're here with Robert. Robert helps us, and he adds something to the team, and that's how you do it. You have to be honest with yourself.
Virgil, you're fluent in Spanish, right?
I can speak Spanish.
What is chavala? Someone says, Elie, you're a chavala.
Chavala is kind of like a...
Like a little girl, like a...
Yeah, like it depends how they use it. If they're your friends, this and that. It depends how they use it.
Chavala. Well, the guy gave a $5 donation. Call me what you want. Just send me the money. I'm cool.
Yeah.
Chavala is like a little girl. Yeah, like a...
A punk, a buster.
Probably not.
Sissy.
Yeah, it depends how you make it. Mexico has the most one word things that can mean a thousand things just the way you say it.
I saw that.
The tone.
Yeah.
I saw that. Like,
what about, like, bah? Like, what does that mean?
Bah.
Just like,
meh. That's what goats say.
Bah. Or you could say, like, surprise, bah.
You can use it in many different forms.
Yeah.